The answer is yes. So what's going to happen is that Ali's vote will remain secret. Bob will be confident that what he's doing is equivalent to Ali's vote. And not even Ali's, because what may happen, the last moment Bob says, I'm going to change my mind and I'm not going to copy Ali's vote. And Ali's even cannot figure that out, that that actually happened or not. So how what we do in practice is we grab the randomness from the browser when Ali is actually casting her vote. And then Bob will actually blind that vote to make sure that Helios is not able to detect that. But that's not enough, because also a proof has to be given, and we make that proof divertible. And there's some difficulties with that, as for example, divertible proofs are actually from the original claim, and it's just that the distribution of what you receive is different. However, here this time now, Bob's want to blind the ciphertext. The second thing is that we have the Fiat Shamir trick, which gives you the questions. But now the ciphertext has been changed, so we have to take care of that. And there were no divertible proofs for disjunctive proofs, and that's actually what's being used in Helios, so we had to deal with that. So the first question you could ask is, why the heck do you want to copy? And so what happens is that one of the problems if with plurality voting, which ISCR uses, is a spoiler effect. That means that you, if you nominate many, 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 many candidates, then what happens is that you're going to get votes to unelectable candidates, and it may imply that some unpopular candidate is going to win. This was already observed by a French scientist called Condorcet. So copying votes can limit actually the impact of a spoiler effect, improving the fairness to other parties. So Helios may actually help fight the spoiler effect. But evidently, if that's done by a lot of people, what the consequences will be is that these candidates now are overrepresented, because everybody else who's going to vote is going to basically spread their votes. And so since Helios is malleable, this might actually be negative. So what I'm going to give as an example, when you talk about Helios, you talk about ISCR elections, okay? And it seems that the French know Condorcet's work very well. Evidently, Condorcet was French. What would you else expect? And so you see that you find 4 out of the 9 ISCR board directors, elected directors, are actually French, okay, folks? So are you upset about that? We will actually have a server for the 2011 elections that will allow you to copy a vote, mine, and I'm not going to run, okay? And I will make sure that my vote is properly balanced among other of all the continents and all the candidates, and look who is actually should be actually on the board. And if you believe that I'm actually the equivalent of Alice in this case, and you trust me, then you can actually copy my vote and we'll have that all running. Evidently, the question is, why Ivo? Why do you want to choose this guy? So yeah, exactly, that's the reaction. So that's why we have future work, where we're going to have basically a distributed voters. We're going to have a number of people who have been a few years on the board, know how it works, who doesn't say a word, who is basically shouting too much, etc. And then actually say, we now are going to select who we think should actually be elected, and then have that copy. The problem then is, yeah, I don't want to reveal my vote, and somebody else doesn't want to reveal his vote, etc. So now you have a distributed voter, and how can you then actually do that? And the answer is today, you can use secure multi-party computation, but it looks as kind of bring an elephant to this room. You know, it would not fit, it wouldn't go through the doors. So the question is there a better solution? And the answer is, we don't know. Thank you. Enjoy the ICR 2011 elections.